بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, I testify that there is no true God worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad is Allah's true slave and messenger. May Allah's salam and salam be upon the noble prophet, his household, and upon the companions and those who follow on their path until the day of resurrection. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from them. We continue the explanation of the three fundamental principles, and we're talking about the kinds of worship which the author rahimahullah cited. He, may Allah's mercy be upon him, mentioned the third type as an example, and this is the ar-raja, which is hope and longing. Hope and longing. We spoke about ad-du'a yesterday, and we spoke about the fear and the awe, and today we'll speak about ar-raja, hope and longing. This is known in Arabic as ar-raja. ودليل الرجاء, and the evidence for رجاء, is in the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Kahf, chapter 18, verse 110. In Surah Al-Kahf, قال الله عز وجل: فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه فليعمل عملا صالحا ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا. And this is verse 110.
قل إنما أنا بشر مثلكم يوحى إلي أنما إلهكم إله واحد فمن كان يرجو لقاء ربه فليعمل عملا صالحا ولا يشرك بعبادة ربه أحدا.
So whoever hopes for the meeting with his Lord, let him work righteousness and associate none as a partner in the worship of his Lord. And the origin of raja, hope and longing, is wishing for something or waiting for something which is beloved. And ar-raja comprises humility and submission, and thus therefore it cannot be except to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, cannot be directed except to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Associating hope with other than Allah is a form of shirk. Now, is it a major or a lesser shirk? This depends. Depends on the state of the heart of the person. It depends upon the state of the heart of the person in this case. And ar-raja is of two types. Ar-raja, hope and longing, is of two types. A praiseworthy type and a blameworthy type. The praiseworthy type is the hope of someone who acts in compliance with Allah's command, hoping for his reward, and a person who commits sins then repents from them, and thus he hopes for forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and pardoning, and goodness, and generosity, and clemency. This is praiseworthy hope and longing. The second type of raja is the blameworthy type, and this is the hope of someone who is transgressing limits in his negligence and sins, hoping for Allah's mercy without any action on his part. To attain and be qualified to attain Allah's mercy. In fact, this is delusion and wishful thinking and false hope. And the difference between hope and wishful thinking is that hope goes with exerting the efforts and with good dependence upon Allah, while the other, at-tamanni, wishing, goes with laziness. قال الله تعالى, الله سبحانه وتعالى said in Surah Al-Isra, chapter 17, verse 57, أولئك الذين يدعون يبتغون إلى ربهم الوسيلة أيهم أقرب ويرجون رحمته ويخافون عذابه.
أولئك الذين يدعون يبتغون إلى ربهم الوسيلة أيهم أقرب ويرجون رحمته ويخافون عذابه إن عذاب ربك كان محذورا.
Those whom they call upon, like Jesus, son of Mary, Maryam, Uzair, the angels, etc., desire for themselves means of access to their Lord, as to which of them should be the nearest, and they hope for his mercy and fear his torment. Verily, the torment of your Lord is something to be afraid of. ابتغاء الوسيلة, seeking means of nearness, means seeking that through love, submission, obedience, and all kinds of legal means that draws the person near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whoever hopes for the meeting with his Lord, let him work righteousness, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Kahf earlier, which we cited. So whoever hopes for the meeting with his Lord, and the meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of resurrection is of two types. One which is particular, and this is for the believers, and through which they will attain the pleasure and the favors from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the other type is general for all people. And the evidence for the general meeting with Allah is the one in Surah Al-Inshiqaq, verses 6 to 10. قال الله تعالى:
يا أيها الإنسان إنك كادح إلى ربك كدحا فملاقيه. فأما من أوتي كتابه بيمينه فسوف يحاسب حسابا يسيرا وينقلب إلى أهله مسرورا. وأما من أوتي كتابه وراء ظهره فسوف يدعو ثبورا ويصلى سعيرا. إنه كان في أهله مسرورا. إنه ظن أن لن يحور. بلى إن ربه كان به بصيرا.
O man, verily you are returning towards your Lord with your deeds and actions, good or bad, a sure returning. So you will meet the results of your deeds which you did. Then as for him who will be given his record in his right hand, he surely will receive an easy reckoning and will return to his family in joy. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from them. But whosoever is given his record behind his back, then فَسَوْفَ يَدْعُوا ثُبُورًا, verse 11. He will invoke for his own destruction. So here, the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ بِيَمِينِهِ, then as for him who will be given his record in his right hand, and the saying of Allah, وَأَمَّا مَنْ أُوْتِيَ كِتَابَهُ وَرَاءَ ظَهْرِهِ, and for whosoever is given his record behind his back, this indicates that the meeting here in these verses is general meeting. It's general meeting. However, in the verse in Surah Al-Kahf, whoever hopes for the meeting with his Lord, the meeting where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be pleased with, let him do righteousness and not ascribe any partners to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his worship. Because the one who hopes for the reward of Allah and fears his punishment will do righteous deeds and will not ascribe partners to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his worship. And the righteous deeds, as explained by the people of knowledge, are those deeds which are pure from showing off and which are in agreement with the revelation. And the saying of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Kahf, وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا, let him not ascribe partners to Allah in his worship, anyone besides Allah in his worship. This means anyone. No angel, no close angel, or a prophet, or a saint, or a righteous. And the saying of Allah, وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ, and let him not ascribe partners in his worship, to his worship of his Lord, Allah. There is here an indication, and a very important one, and let us really contemplate it. It means فكما أن ربك الذي خلقك. Since Allah is the one who created you and nourished you and no one shared with him anything of that, فيجب أن تكون العبادة له وحده لا شريك له. Therefore worship must be purely and sincerely done with him, ascribing no one else with him in your worship. And therefore here it is incumbent upon the slave to manifest his hope by directing it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not thinking that it is because of his own power or because of his own knowledge. Similarly, he should not make it dependent upon any creature. It is a famous saying attributed to Ali ibn Abi Talib, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, that he said, لا يرجو عبد إلا ربه. No slave really hopes except for his Lord, except in his Lord. ولا يخاف إلا ذنبه. And the true slave does not fear except his sin. And in the hadith reported from the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام on the authority of Anas, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, that the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام entered one day and there was a young man in a state of death. So he told him, how do you find yourself? He said, أرجو الله يا رسول الله. I hope, I have hope in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, O Messenger of Allah. وأخاف ذنوبي. And I fear for my sins. So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, these two are not combined in the heart of a slave under this state, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him that which he hoped for and render him secure from that which he feared. And this is reported by Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah, and al-Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah authenticated it. And the one of us should know, the stronger he or she has hope in Allah, seeking his bounties, his mercy, seeking to make his affairs easy, seeking him to repel off that which is harmful, except that the one's slavery to Allah is intensified and strengthened, and his liberation from other than Allah, except that it is intensified and strengthened. And to the contrary, if he hopes in a created being or gets attached to him, then his heart will be directed away from slavery to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he becomes and she becomes a slave to other than Allah to an extent proportional to the degree of attachment his or her heart is to this created being. And thus he or she will be humiliated. Shaykh al-Islam rahimahullah has a precious words in this regard. He said, know that the agitators of the hearts that leads to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are three: love, fear, and hope. And the strongest is love. And it is sought for itself, because it is sought in this life and the hereafter. contrary to fear, because fear will not be present in the hereafter. قال الله تعالى, in this respect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Yunus verse 62,
ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون الذين آمنوا وكانوا يتقون لهم البشرى في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة لا تبديل لكلمات الله ذلك هو الفوز العظيم.
No doubt, verily the awliya, those who believe in tawheed and comply with Allah's commands and abstain from His prohibitions and love Allah much, no fear shall come upon them, nor shall they grieve. And he added, rahimahullah, that the point about fear is to deter and to prevent from straying from the path. So love leads the slave on his march to his beloved one, and depending on its strength and weakness, such as his sayr, his walk, his journey to Allah will be accordingly. Well, khawf and fear prevents him from going off the path of the beloved one. وَالرَّجَاءُ يَقُودُ, and hope and longing leads him. فَهَذَا أَصْلٌ عَظِيمٌ, and thus this is a great foundation. Every slave should give attention to that. For فَإِنَّهُ لَا تَحْصُلُ لَهُ الْعُبُدِيَّةُ بِدُونِهِ, indeed slavery cannot be attained except through this. And everyone should be a slave to Allah and to none else. If it is said that sometimes the slave may not have the love that incites him to seek his beloved one, so what will motivate his heart? He said, rahimahullah, two things will do that. One is kathratu dhikri al-mahbub, abundant remembrance of the beloved, because this will lead to attachment of the heart to the beloved one. The second is examining and pondering about his signs and his favors. And when the slave remembers and ponders about or concerning the favors that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given him from making the heavens and the earth and what therein from the trees and animals subservient to him, and whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed upon him from the inward and outward favors, from the iman, faith, and other than that, then all of this will inevitably incite in him the motivation. Similarly, fear is motivated through examining the verses, the revelations concerning the threats and warnings and the day of resurrection and what goes on there from the horrors. And similarly, al-raja, hope is motivated through examining the generosity and the clemency and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. These were based upon Imam Ibn Qayyim, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, concerning the connection between love, fear and hope, and which came in his book Majmu' al-Fatawa, the collection of Fatawa, volume 1, verses pages 95 and 96. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make our hearts filled with love, fear and hope in accordance with the way that leads us to the complete slavery to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to attain His pleasure and to be from amongst those who will meet Him and see His face on the day of resurrection. إنه ولي ذلك والقادر عليه. والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. This constitutes number 14 from this series of the discussion on the three fundamental principles, and it completed on this night, the night on the of the 18th of Rabi' al-Awwal, the third Islamic month, corresponding to April 26, 2005.